Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation series, where we are exploring the first learning path, prepare the data. In this video, we are going to look at the topic, identify when to use reference or duplicate queries and the resulting impact, which is part of the section transform and load the data. We have already looked at reference in a few videos, and we know that reference is used to create a copy of the query. And we have been using reference to create copies from the staging area to the data modeling area. Now we are going to have a look at duplicate, which effectively does the same thing, but there is a difference between reference and duplicate. And then we are going to see the resulting impact. Now let's go back to the Power Query editor and see the difference between reference and duplicate. I am back inside the Power Query editor, where I can see these six queries that are inside the data modeling area of the query editor. All of these queries have been generated by using reference to create a copy. So initially we had the queries in the staging area, and then by using reference, the queries in the data model area were created. Now let's go and see another area where we can better understand the effect of this operation, where we were using reference to create a copy. For that, I need to go inside the view area, and then I find an option which says query dependency. So this is the last option that you can see in this ribbon. So I'm going to click on query dependencies now. This opens up a new window. So let me just expand this window, and I can use the zoom option at the bottom to just increase the size of this so that I can see all of the boxes here clearly. So now let's highlight a couple of these boxes here in this area and look what is happening here. So here you can see that I have three boxes. The first box here, it represents the Maven market customers.csv file. So this is exactly the path of the Maven market customers file, the initial file to which we connected through the Power Query editor. Then this is the Maven market underscore customers query, which is there in the staging area. And then this is the customers query, which is now in the data modeling area. So once I connected to the data source, this was the initial query that was created, and then you can see then this is the further customers query that was created once I used a reference. So you can see that there are arrows which show some kind of a sequence between the data source and the customers query, which is inside the data modeling. Similarly, you can see it for the stores, you can see it for the returns, you can see it for the calendar, and you can see it for all the others. So you have some kind of a relationship represented by the arrows which flow from the source to the final query inside the data modeling area. Now I'm going to go back to the instruction sheet, and there is just one file to which we have still not connected. And we are going to connect to that file, but instead of creating a copy through the reference, we are going to make a copy through the duplicate option. And then once we have done that, we are going to come back to this diagram again and see if there is any difference. So I have closed the query dependency video, and I'm back in the instruction.pdf file, which we have already used in a lot of previous videos. And the only part that we haven't covered is the serial 7, and we need to go and connect to the Maven market region CSV file. And instead of using reference, which is mentioned here, we are going to use duplicate to create a copy. So first we are going to connect to the file, then we are go, and then once it is there in the staging layer, we are going to use duplicate instead of reference to create a copy, and then we are going to rename it to regions and check the data type. So now let's go back to the Power Query editor. I'm back in the Power Query editor, and in the staging area, now I am going to connect to the Maven market regions file and bring it inside the staging area. So here I have selected the Maven market region CSV file. I'm going to click here on open, and it is going to show me the preview and then I'm going to bring this regions file inside the staging area. So here you can see that the Maven market regions file has been successfully brought into the staging area. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps that I do every time. The first step is to uncheck the enable load, and then instead of creating a copy through the reference, now I am going to click on duplicate and create a copy. So here now I'm going to click on duplicate. So the copy has been created. So I'm going to just drag it into the data model area, and then I'm going to rewrite the name as regions, or I'm going to rename it as the regions. Immediately, one difference that we can see is that once we have used a duplicate, the new query that has been created, which is the copied version, if I just go and right click on this, you will see that the enable load option is not checked here. So I just need to go and click on the enable load option so that this regions query is similar to the queries, all the other queries in the data model region. Now I am going to go and click on the query dependencies window again and see the difference that what this duplicate has created inside that view. I am inside the query dependencies window, and the area that we need to focus is this area and this area. So here you can see that this is the Maven market regions file, and you see that now there are two arrows that are coming out of this source file. So we have the Maven market regions box, which represents the query inside the staging area, and then we have the regions query, which is inside the data modeling area. But now instead of this regions query being connected to the regions, Maven market underscore regions query in the staging area, it is directly connected to the source. So this is the difference, the very obvious difference that we see, that instead of connecting to this query, which is the query inside the staging area, now the query that has been created through the duplicate, it is connecting directly to the source. So this is a very obvious difference that can be seen. So now let's go back to the queries area and see what other differences are there, and then I'm going to explain what is actually happening. I'm back inside the Power Query editor, and I have selected the regions query here, and now the area that we are going to look at is the area in the applied steps. So here you see that in the applied steps, we have three applied steps: source, promoted, headers, and change type. So these are the three steps that are there. And if I go and click on the initial query inside the staging area, I am going to see the same three steps inside the applied steps area of the staging area query, Maven market underscore regions, which was used to create a copy, which is this returns, but this, the regions, but this was done using the duplicate option. Now let's go and see any other query that was created using the reference option. Now let's look at the returns query here. So if you remember from one of the videos, that for the returns query, we used the Maven market returns 1997-98, and then we just used reference to create this returns query here. First, let's go and see the original query inside the staging area. And here, if I just go and highlight the applied steps, I see three steps: source, promoted, headers, and change type. But now if I just go and click on the returns inside the data model, the returns query that was created using reference, here I am just seeing the source applied step. And obviously we did not do any transformation on this query, so there was no other step that was performed. But the important thing to note here is that by creating a copy, the only step that was created is the source step. Whereas in the returns query, there are three applied steps. So what is actually happening here? And we have already seen that this is not the case once we look at the regions query. So we haven't done anything, any transformation on the regions query as yet, but still we see the three applied steps here, which are similar to the applied steps which are there in the original file through which the duplicate option was used to create a copy. So what is actually happening here? So once we are using reference is just like creating a mathematical equation where you are creating a new variable and assigning the previous variable to a new variable. And that is why we see a connectivity, the arrow which is between the query inside the staging area and the query which is inside the data modeling area, that the arrow actually represents that equality. And if I just go and click on the returns area here and show you what is the M code generated. So if I just go and just look at this, so this is the M code, which is just an equality sign, which is reference, which is just equaling to the original query inside the staging area. But if I just go and see what is happening for the regions query, this is not exactly the case. So once we are using duplicate, what duplicate does is that it creates an exact clone. So it creates an exact copy of your original query, and that original query has nothing to do with the query inside the staging areas. And that is why you do not see any arrow or any connectivity in the Maven market regions query. Once we saw it in the query dependency video, that in the query dependency window, that the connectivity is on the source itself. So it is like having an exact copy or an exact clone. And that is why we saw that the regions query had the enable load flag unchecked, because the original Maven market underscore regions has also this as unchecked. So in short, once we are talking about duplicate, we are talking about creating an exact clone that has all the applied steps. So if this query Maven market regions had 20 applied steps here, then this regions query would also had 20 applied steps. Does not matter that what are those applied steps, it is going to create an all those applied steps, because it is directly linking it to the source. So that is why it has to copy all the applied steps. But for the case where we are looking at the other queries that were created using reference, that's not the case. So it is just taking the last step and then taking it to the new query that is created in the data model area, and it is just referring through an equality sign. So it is just referencing it as if there is a equality sign, as a variable has been assigned to another variable. Once we are working inside a Power Query editor where we have a staging area and a data model area, we always prefer to use reference to make copies so that we have a logical connectivity between the queries in the staging area and the queries in the data model area. We only use duplicate where we have a limitation of the reference. And what is that limitation? Now let me just go back into the query dependency window again and show you what is that dependency. Here, if we just have a look at the Maven market customers query, so here this is the query in the staging area and this is the query in the data modeling area. So the dependency here is that the customers query is a child of the Maven market customers, which is the parent. So this is a parent child relationship. So the child is dependent on the parent, but the parent is not dependent on the child. So this thing you need to remember. So in a scenario where you want some operation, where you want to do some operation that goes against this parent-child relationship. So let's say, and we are going to see it in a few future videos, that we want to do an operation which we do on the parent, but it has a dependency on the child. then this relationship won't hold. And it is, and Power Query is not, it will not allow you to do such operations. So some of the examples could be once we look at the merging or once we look at appending. So if we want to create a relationship, a reverse relationship where the parent is dependent on the child, then Power Query is not going to allow us to do that. And the only option there is to use the duplicate instead of the reference. Another use of duplicate is in a very specific scenario where you have multiple files. And let's say you connect to a CSV file, bring it into Power Query, and you perform 5, 7, 10 operations inside the Power Query editor. And then you need to go and connect to another file. And you have to perform all the steps that you performed on the first file on the second file. Then instead of using reference, you can use duplicate, where you can just create a copy of the first file, create a new query, and in the new query, just go and change the path to the second file. So just create a copy and then just go to the first step and change the file path of the file from the first file to the second file. So that is how you can reduce your working, and all the steps that you performed on the first file are automatically replicated in the second file. So in this video, we have talked in detail about the difference between reference and duplicate, and also discussed briefly the scenarios where you can use reference, and in the scenarios where duplicate can be a good alternative to reference. So just remember the points related to reference and duplicate. You might get one question on the exam, or might be one part of a bigger question related to reference and duplicate. So just keep these points in mind. We are going to address something more related to reference and duplicate in a few other videos. But that is all for this video, and I will see you in the next one.